Hey there, happy days. Sharon Horn-Elstrom here. Can you use grasping at straws to supersize and grow your business? Do you think you can? Well, you know me, I like to argue circularly, so I think that you can use the expression grasping at straws to grow and build your business. I'll get to that in a minute, but first I want to talk about what does it mean, where did it come from, and how have you probably experienced it, or are people around you experiencing it right now, if not continuously in the past? They're still probably experiencing it in many ways today. I know I see people grasping at straws all the time. I make a concerted effort to not grasp at straws, but sometimes I'm sure I do the same thing, just like everybody else does. Grasping at straws is a saying that means, of course, to depend on something useless in a time of trouble, to make a hopeless effort to try to do something, to kind of make a hopeless effort to save yourself when the chances of saving yourself are slim to none in a situation. It also means to try something with little or no hope of success. Now, when you succeed, people call it a Hail Mary. I like to think of it as an exercise in futility. I think my mom used to say that all the time. This is an exercise in futility, meaning you're putting a whole bunch of effort into something and the chance of success is slim to none. Ancient people made this up when they were describing, of course, drowning people. When somebody's drowning, they're flailing around, their arms are flailing, and they're you know, screaming and yelling and bobbing under, up and down underwater, grabbing at anything that they can grab at to try to save themselves, to get a footing or to grab at hollow wee reeds along the shoreline of a river or something. But chances are those aren't gonna support them. They're not gonna give them the grasp that they need to pull themselves out and save themselves. And that's where the expression originally came from. In the 1600s, it was used to describe any situation that was pretty much hopeless, or the chance of, it was used to describe people depending on something that was pretty much useless to get them out of any sort of trouble or danger. You know, it's kind of like taking a knife to a gunfight, or I guess that's a pretty good example, taking a knife to a gunfight. There's so many examples of this around us now today in business and in some of our businesses and some of our businesses in the past. Anybody that thinks that their product is for everybody, everybody on the planet needs my product, everybody on the planet needs my water. See this a lot in network marketing industry. Everybody, my product's for everybody. New people always think that their product is for everybody. Well, if you think your product's for everybody, that's an exercise in futility. It's grasping at straws, because it's like throwing spaghetti at the wall and seeing what will stick, or having a bunch of different strategies, a bunch of different hacks. You're trying a different thing every day, like a flavor of the month. Remember when I first got online and was attracted to and interested in things online, there were people that I would watch, and they would have like a product or service of the month that they were selling. Every month it was something different. Sometimes every week it was something different. Well, I never followed those people because you don't trust them. They're just throwing things out to see what people would be attracted to and buy. Not a great strategy. It's number one, expensive. It's kind of an exercise in futility in that chances are you will run out of resources before you get that one thing that works. Unless you stick with it long enough, then you're bound to find something that will work for you. Not the best strategy of coming up with what it is you want to provide for products and services to people that you want to serve. Dumping money into a sinking ship. I've done some real estate projects and houses that were just money pits. A money pit, like, I don't know if you've seen the movie The Money Pit, that would be a good example of kind of an exercise in futility, although they did pull that off in the movie. Filibustering would be a political example of grasping at straws. Sometimes debates and arguments will grasp at straws by bringing up everything from the past or all kinds of irrelevant or unrelated topics in an argument in an effort to win the argument. That's definitely grasping at straws, when you're bringing up things that aren't related in order to try to win your side of the argument as a last-ditch effort. Throwing all sorts of things out there. An example in the online world that I've personally experienced is the shiny object syndrome, where you're chasing after different things and in this learning loop of learning all the time and not applying what you learn. That is grasping at straws, thinking that you're gonna learn your way to success without ever applying any of that success is grasping at straws. So how can you take this concept, grasping at straws, knowing that people try things and quit, or they blame or victimize, make excuses, or have a scarcity mentality. How do you take all of that, all of this grasping at straws behavior, and turn it into a way to supersize and grow your business? Well, the best way to do that is by knowing that what are the things that your customers, your ideal people, not everybody, but the people that you're here to serve, the specific target group you're here to serve, what problems do they have that they're grasping at solving, and they're just, what things are they already doing and trying that they're not having success with? The difference between what they want and what they're trying that isn't working, there's a gap between that. If you fill that gap, that is the key to growing and supersizing and building your business. Be the person that gives them the absolute solution from and gets them the transformation or the result from where they are to where they want to be. Filling that gap, knowing that they're grasping at straws and they're working and doing things that aren't working, how do you position yourself and get your company and your solutions in the hands of the people so that they are no longer grasping at straws, so that they do get the results that they want, so that you can serve them at the highest, best level, and they can achieve what it is that they're wanting to have, do, be, or achieve. That's it. Go out, look for people that are grasping at straws in your group, in your ideal client base, and see how you can better serve them. See how you can help them to actually get the solutions that they want. That's how we grow and build our businesses. That's it. If I can help you in any way, or if you've got a great story about grasping at straws, or an example of how people grasp at straws, share in the comments below, because I would love to know. Otherwise, have an amazing day, and I will, of course, be with you tomorrow with another interesting idiom. Where did it come from? What does it mean? How can you use that and open your mind to see different ways of growing and building your business? Because that's what we all want to do, right? We all want to create an impact in the world that hopefully makes the world a better place. All right. Catch you tomorrow. Bye.